Yeah, I think I'll just hold it. Can everyone hear me? Is that okay? Yeah. Just hold it here. Brilliant. Thank you. So for those of you that don't know me, my name is Helen Simpson. I'm Strategic Relationship Manager for Housing at Greater Manchester Health and Social Care Partnership. And as Warren just said, we're going to the slides that we're going to run through are a bit of an overview of the work that we've been doing so far on our Greater Manchester Healthy Homes programme. I'm just going to give you a bit of an overview of that and an update, and we'll then also move on to the planned engagement and consultation that we've got coming up over the coming months, which hopefully resonates a little bit more with the conversation you've been having this morning. I'm actually hoping that the overview of the work that we've done so far, again, picks up on some of those organisational recommendations that you were talking about this morning. So hopefully, like as well said, there'll be quite a lot of interest in here for you, and hopefully this is again the start of an ongoing conversation with the network on this piece of work. So why a housing programme in the Health and Social Care Partnership? I'm sure we're all aware that where we live and who we live with has a massive impact on our mental health, on our physical health, on our well-being. If you're living in cold, damp homes, that has an impact potentially, or it can create or exacerbate existing long-term conditions. If you're living in unsafe accommodation, that can contribute to accidents and falls in the home. Maybe if you've got nowhere to live at all, we know that homelessness is both a cause and a contributing factor to really poor health and well-being outcomes. And all of these things kind of culminate in can culminate in an excessive use of health and care services for individuals. So probably no surprise that a huge figure up there, a cost of £1.4 billion, the cost of poor housing to the NHS, and that's just first year treatment costs on an annual basis. So obviously housing does have an enormous impact on health and wellbeing, but also on the use of our health and care services. And then just getting a bit further into detail around sort of aids and adaptations and the accessibility and suitability of where we live. Again, some pretty big figures up there. Living somewhere that is accessible and suitable can obviously increase, or we could have a swifter discharge from hospital. Again, it can prevent falls, it increases quality of life, it can ensure that people are able to fully access their property. And then there was some research done recently by foundations that was able to demonstrate that if you put an aid or an adaptation into someone's home that they need, it can potentially delay an admission into residential care by 4 years, which is just, you know, it's a fantastic kind of headline that, which, you know, allows keeping people living independently at home, but then also the consequence, the impact on like social care budgets as well, which you can demonstrate through that. So this, you know, this is a big deal. Housing is a big deal when we're talking about people's health and well-being. And on the back, and I guess from a housing perspective, home improvement agencies or traditional sort of healthy home services have always been able to mitigate some of that risk. So by providing really practical advice and information on how people can live independently, on making repairs and adaptations to their home, they've traditionally been able to provide those services. So in acknowledgement of that, Health and Social Care Partnership, and specifically our population health plan, set out an opportunity for us to be able to start to explore a Greater Manchester-wide healthy home service that would start to encompass some of these services and those mitigating factors, but also looking at what we've already got and how we make the most of that. What a Greater Manchester Health Home Service might look like. So what needs should we be trying to address? What type of services are important to people? And how should we try and ensure a consistent sort of baseline offer across the 10 localities? Because I'm sure you're all aware these services at the minute, across Greater Manchester, there is great variation. You're almost getting into the situation of a postcode lottery. So for those of you who aren't necessarily immediately familiar with healthy homes or those traditional home improvement agency services, this slide just gives a bit of an overview. All of these services exist in some way, shape or form across the 10 localities in Greater Manchester. There's not one locality that would have all of these services. There is a huge variation in them. Because we know those services exist and we now understand a lot more about them, we know that the impact that they can have, and we need to consider them when we're thinking about this provision across Greater Manchester. So down this side of the slide, lots of kind of really practical assistance, home improvements, handy person services, disabled adaptations. And then the far side of the slide, looking more at, as the home improvement agency sets kind of evolved over the last few years, become much more responsive to people's health and care needs, more focused around independent living and looking at things like hospital discharge, the use of technology and technology-enabled care, really trying to kind of branch out into meeting people's health and social care needs. So what, with the Healthy Homes programme, what we wanted to do was kind of look at all of that, take all of that learning, not just from within Greater Manchester, but nationally as well, to look at what would be the best service that we could provide, or look at providing across Greater Manchester. And that's with a bit of kind of pragmatism as well, so understanding what resources are in the system, being a bit realistic about what and what we can provide within that envelope, but also being a bit innovative about using the existing funding that we've already got and how we can use that to shape services going forwards. So over the last few months, we've been working with an organisation called Foundations. They're the national body for home improvement agencies and disabled adaptations to really give us a steer and some recommendations on how we might look at creating a Greater Manchester offer around healthy home services, very much based on our understanding of the services that already exist, but how do we build on that? How do we help those services to grow and expand potentially across other local authority boundaries? They've done a lot of work on helping us understand what would the best services be to meet individual needs, but also meet health and social care needs, also start to improve the condition of our housing stock as well, so trying to cross all of those different priorities. To come up with some very clear recommendations for us. And I guess this is where the engagement and the consultation process starts for us. So from these recommendations that Foundations have suggested around a baseline of services, so what would be the things that we can build on existing services, set up in the short term across Greater Manchester that might be easier to do and that also would have the most impact. So advice and information, real advice and information on housing and care options, handy person services, services that already exist but we need to probably draw better together around keeping people warm at home, and also our disabled adaptation service, which is already a statutory service in all the local authority areas, but actually how can we make that better and how can we make it faster and more effective as well. A couple of suggestions of enhanced services that maybe we could look at in the longer term. But alongside all of this, a series of challenges. So, and asking us in Greater Manchester to kind of reflect a little bit on how do we make the best use of our existing adapted housing stock? How do we make the best use of our partners and the relationships that we've got across Greater Manchester to build something that's not just necessarily kind of statutory services and locality and local authority focused, but also as well challenges not to be as inward looking, so starting to look at what's going on elsewhere, what other models of provision work really well, what best practice exists nationally, as well as within Greater Manchester. And again, one of the main themes of this, the recommendations that came back from Foundations, was around making sure this is a Greater Manchester piece of work, and that's where those themes around consultation and engagement come into this. So if we want this to be owned by the Greater Manchester system, then we need to make sure that we've got that buy-in. We want to come and talk to people about it, and we want people to influence and shape the way these services start to look as we go forwards. So, and this kind of really informs our next steps around what we want to do with this work. We're currently undertaking a bit of a review of the work Foundations have done for us, just kind of sense-checking those services that already exist in localities before we start to kind of build on that. But mainly trying to map out who are the people we want to go and talk to about this. So there's the obvious big players in this, as I'm sure you'd imagine. So all of our health and social care partners and organisations, the combined authority, the 10 local authorities, our housing provider partners who've been really integral in getting this piece of work to this point, really supportive, voluntary community sector organisations utilising the network that Warren just touched on, the ageing hub. But one of the things they really focused on was how we need to really proactively engage with people who are first of all already providing these services across Greater Manchester and use their knowledge and expertise of the sector to inform this, but also the people who use these services or might be using these services in future. And I guess that's where yourselves come into this conversation and groups like this. You know, we want to attend as many meetings and forums and host workshops as much as we can, really, to ensure that we've got that feedback, that we've got that input into these services, so we've got that feedback, and it can really shape how this starts to look going forward. So I guess it's a very, very quick run through at this point, but a bit of a plea to be able to come back and talk to you about these services and the propositions in more detail so that we can get that input from the network. So thank you very much for your time. I'm going to pass back over.